it's fantastic to be here, and great to be in this amazing lineup. And wow, like open micers are awesome here. So, I was chatting to just Leslie sitting down there before, and we were talking about the kind of the wildness of London, and I seem to get into those conversations a lot. And I'm going to do an amalgamation piece, looking at the light and the dark side of the city, and see what we think. A kid tap dances on the streets of London, each tap of the sole of his shoes tapping. He dances because he was born with a restlessness in his legs, and when he moves them all the colours come together. He dances outside because rooms are too small, takes the street corners where the winds are his horns. They howl and they whoop through the rhythms he falls through. On the paving slabs that flatten the soil where his ancestors rest. He draws their spirits with the ripple of his feet. They speak through the cracks, feelings seep through the concrete. Each cobblestone foxtrotting stories and songs. Yeah, his father was a fisherman. He tastes sea salt in the air. His uncle laid brick. He built cities with his fingers. His grandmother knew depression. He shakes dust from his shoes, takes ground, claims back places erased from his blood. The blood. His mother would always say to him, the greatest antidote to fear is love. Keep moving, baby. Keep alive. Never let them steal you. He laughs in the face of cynics. Keeps the city alive with grins and giggles. Keep moving. Keep moving. Arms bend and fingers click. Throws heels, ears, big band, trumpets, drum hits. Feels jives, smells dance halls. The hips, the hands, the screeches. Beneath the jazz he tastes blues and slow moving lullabies like his grandmother used to rock him to sleep. Further still he hears the sound of spirituals, of African hands clap foreign soil. Hears the thwack of tools and picks and sickles for iron and steel beats the saddest songs. And so within the giggles he leaves room for tears, for the voices that spoke his coal-coloured skin, lets them splash untinged from scrunched up eyes, as his head was the blast off of another perfect spin. The hooded girl looks on, eyes wired and bouncing her head. She clutches notepad in hand, taps a pen to her hip. She drinks him in, hearing hip-hop and bass lines and the stuff of his shoes. Tonight, she will write him in the cold council room with fingers drumming the footsteps he laid. Scratch pen on paper in rhythms of snares, not scrunched up pages at damp beaten walls, and she clocks that elusive, that perfect flow. In time, she will recite him in bars and theatres to reaching crowds and bouncing heads. But for now, she memorises, locks him inside her, folds her paper to the shape of a plane, opens her window and throws it headlong into the wind that moves across the city. If I could take war to one end, it would be isolation. If I could join forces or court with the warmongers, guide the nations to storm on the walls of oppression, I'd take canvas, I'd take brush, I'd paint the shape of London like the shape of a dove, and with its tears, write a manifesto against loneliness. I see a pestilence that clings to this city like a leech, pulling gags over speech and shackles over hands, that causes the lonely to wander streets, heads bowed, dragging chains on feet, wailing slave songs to the beat of a drum that won't sleep, but beats from the walls of our dreams till our dreams weep into waking. I see a new kind of slavery, man, one that's moved into minds, moved into homes, cut phone lines, pulled blinds, shut shutters, locked locks, stopped clocks, propped blockades up on doors, not nails through mailboxes. One that has succinctly turned this city into a prison for the ignored, for the forgotten, for the disaffected, for the displaced. I walk London streets infected by it, taste its tears in the gutters. How can a city so full of people, or a people so estranged from each other? Because I see walls moving between us like snakes, bending to fit the shapes of low self-esteem, restlessness, lost dreams, resentment, greed, meaningless meetings when all we want is meaning. All we want is skin on skin touch and love rush that hushes the pain of our lostness, that says, you belong, son. You're wanted. But what scares me more is what I don't see. The lonely wounds, the missing daughters, the lost sons, caught up in the dungeons of London shadows where souls are outrun, strung high on the gallows of time run low, growing old in the coldness of no one knowing and the stone cold living of life alone. How many are there that we don't know about, slipping through the city like ghosts, holding lives unnoticed and souls erased, till all that's left are posters floating on the wind with the word missing printed above a forgotten face. So here's my declaration, my war cry signed with the blood of lost hearts. Here's my cry for the emancipation of my people to rise up, to drive the forces of isolation from our mindsets, from our children, from our homes, from the borders that close around the throat of hope. Here's my cry to the spirit of belonging, to weep spring rain on the wings of this city, to wet the wells of union, kiss the springs of touch, let embrace rise again like an angel awakened from the dust of our lungs. Thank you.
When I'm not doing poetry, I work with children. One thing that I absolutely love to do with children is to tell them stories, and quite often when I'm telling stories, they will help me to make stories up, and it's just amazing really, I think, how children kind of take to stories and remember them and live them out. And this next poem that I'm, and my last poem actually that I'm going to perform, is one that was kind of loosely based on a story that I made out with a class about a boy who goes searching for what the most beautiful word in the world is. So yeah, I was really inspired by that idea, and I just kind of wrote this poem out of that. And I've got some visual aids. I think the people at the back can see them. I asked you once what the most beautiful word was. You told me to close my eyes so you could show me the strains of the world. When I opened them again, we were on the streets of Marrakesh, where the dust was as dry as an ocean unwept. We found a man in a market selling china cups. He held one to us and said, at night, these look like swans floating in the dust. But when you turn into the moonlight, you can drink the stars. There is no word as vast as porcelain. We were cast to the shores of the Kenyan beach, where the childless woman stood like a vase, feet wet in the night, hands stretched to a waiting womb. As her eyes turned to ours, she spoke to the tide. This hope is life. A bird set free, pulled the sleeve of her blouse, showed the word yearn as henna on her wrist. There is no word as beautiful as this, she whispered, as her eyes turned to silence in the weeds of the night. We fell from her tears, moved to the benches of Moscow where an old man sat. He told us to hold out our hands, skin flat to the sky, to let the white land and fall to our flesh, to count each flake and feel the hush, how each second passing is one closer to death. The word that forms my every breath is birth, and I'm numb with worth like this. He spoke through the kiss of another Russian winter. We respond to the sons of Delhi, traded bread with beggars for the breath of their thoughts. One such man, worn and weary, spoke deepest of them all. My friends, I have seen a million suns rise on the parchment of these streets. I've seen its literature written with the blood of men and the tears of angels. I've thought things too great for my hands. I've drained every possibility from my mind. I have filled libraries with my questions, and thus my dreams are empty. Yet one word fills every corner of my sea. It is this word you seek. Come. We respond to the sons of Delhi, and everyone who has been there. We were undone to the forest of Bavaria, to the porch of a cabin where a lodman sat. Held in his hands was a fallen branch, undressed and cut with the blade of his knife. This wood tells stories, he told us. Each line a rhythm, each pattern a dream. There's a song in every door frame and a journey in every beam. He spoke of the voices of the forest and the way the leaves fall. As he finished, he held up his craft. The word silence etched wet into the flesh of the wood. Next, we stood on the edge of Times Square, made our way to a cafe and sat with our thoughts. There, a waitress brought us coffee, and as we talked, set the folded note beneath the cups. It read, my life is built from snapshots, faces and voices that never return. I once saw a man who looked like my father. The word you want for is somewhere, as she disappeared on the wings of an Atlantic storm. We were flung to the decks of an ocean trawler, soaked wet in a sort of unending waves, crouched on the hub of the bow as a sailor who beckoned us to the cover of the canvas sheet. Thus he started to speak. I have warred 1,000 oceans, battled the rage of the wildest squalls. I have lost life to the wrath of nature, seen sights that have caused me to be born again. Once I saw a girl in a cove in St. Lucia, where the sea was as still as the blue of her eyes. Her skin was like copper, and her name was Glimmer. It is this word that comes in the watches of the night, the word I cradle in my arms like the warmth of my flesh. No man could utter a sweeter breath. He wept as we fell through the depths of a deeper ocean, came to the playgrounds of London, made our way to the quietest child, lost in the noise of a world she couldn't understand. Gave her our hands, let her trace her thoughts in the flesh of our palms, so she beckoned us closer, spoke the word, whisper into the mist of our ears. We traveled like this for years, searched every corner of every land, gathered passions in our pockets and questions in our bags, until one night we found a cave by a sea where the moon coloured the walls like rain. Here we found it, quivering like a fold beneath the folds of a rock. You caught it up in your arms and held it like a child, tears dressing your cheeks like the years we've lost. You gave it to me, its breath on your kiss. I felt a sun rise in my chest. You told me to close my eyes so you could show me the strength of the world. Thank you very much. Cheers.